The NFL draft wrapped up this weekend, shattering viewership records with over 55 million people tuning in over the three-day event as sports-hungry fans across the country and really across the world tuned in for one of the rare few live sports events left on the calendar. Commissioner Roger Goodell kicked off the event from his basement, and he has insisted that the league is going to go forward and they're going to figure out a way to have some football. Now, this was a draft unlike any seen before. It was done completely virtually. It was supposed to happen in Las Vegas, near the Bellagio fountains, with thousands of fans and photographers and a big platform for all of these tremendous athletes to really celebrate being picked up by a team. Instead, the league had over 600 cameras distributed across households, you know, across the country, and prospects really just got to celebrate with their families in their living rooms. Now, of course, the big star of the show was Heisman Trophy winning quarterback Joe Burrow. He and LSU just picked up the National College Championship, and he had the kind of season that most college players could really only dream of. He set an NCAA record for 60 touchdown passes in 15 starts, and he led the country in passing yards, total offense, completion percentage. This guy is really the whole package, and the Cincinnati Bengals were all too happy to pick him up at number one. He was part of a really rich quarterback draft. There were three quarterbacks who were taken in the first six picks. That's something that hasn't happened since 1999, so it just really speaks to the level of talent that was available for teams in the quarterback position. One team that notably did not pick up a quarterback were the New England Patriots. They lost their two-decade-long star quarterback Tom Brady in the offseason after six Super Bowl wins, and he just decided to restart over in Tampa Bay. Now, Joe Burrow, when he does get to Cincinnati, he's going to have a lot of really talented receivers to work with. The team took T. Higgins, a wide receiver out of Clemson, in the second round. And of course, there's A.J. Green. Bengals recently attached the franchise tag to Green, and when he is healthy and injury-free, he is one of the most reliable top talents in the league. Now, speaking of that LSU championship-winning team, they had 14 players picked up in that draft. It's a huge number of people. Everybody from quarterback Burrow to even their long snapper got picked up this year, which really speaks to the level of talent they showed. To put that in perspective, they tied Ohio State for the record for most players picked up in a single draft class in the seven-round era. So LSU has got a lot to celebrate after this weekend. Now, leading up to the draft, there was a lot of concern that having these picks done virtually could lead to, you know, technological glitches or even hackers. Teams and coaches said that they really beefed up their IT departments. Leading up to the draft, the Detroit Lions had an IT camper camped out in the driveway. The WNBA really set a path for them in a lot of senses, because they had their own draft in a similar format less than a week earlier, and theirs went off without a hitch, and so did the NFL's. Really just kind of a major push among the league and also just individual franchises to make sure this draft was successful.